Charles Judge. Good evening.
Good evening, Mr. Judge.
If you will, state your name and address for the record.
My name is Charles Robert Judge. I live at 1739 B Poplar Street in Remington, Georgia. What I want to bring forth is something that, that needs to be addressed, and I don't want to have any backlash from it, but here's the thing, there's crime being covered up in this county, and I was assaulted by my employer. He's John Corbett, our local Georgia Assembly person's brother that owns the Warhol. Got his transcript, I got his arrest, got a warrant for his arrest. I had to go get a criminal warrant. And like most people, if somebody assaults you, they put that person in jail. No, I had to go get a criminal warrant, and I managed to do that. And then Ashley Polk shut it down when he said,
If you don't mind, can you refrain from naming people until we can talk afterwards?
Okay,
I mean, just if it's okay with you, I prefer that.
I don't want to be in this position, but I am. And I was hurt really bad by this guy. And it took me 2 years of recovery. I'm still in recovery. I mean, he was so hard, he busted my eardrum. And I didn't just stand there and take it. I think he thought I was going to fall down and win because he's done this to people before. Five others came out in this transcript. And when I didn't stand there, I hit him back. He tried to get a gun, and I made sure that he did not get that gun by kicking him several times and yelled for the police, but the police didn't get there. Our former chief of the police gave me, he read these transcripts and read the transcripts of the other people who saw what happened. He got me what I needed to get the man arrested, and he retired. Had anything to do with me, and I probably did. But your mind goes wandering. Like I said, I went to a lawyer, a couple of them, talked to them. They gave me, I thought they were friends of mine, so you don't get to name names, but I talked to both of them, and the two lived next door to each other. And one said, next door neighbor, he's going to be busy. Then this other friend of mine, I know he'd do you right. This has been since 2016. I haven't seen any justice in the courtroom. This man's rich. He could, if I was lying and he was telling the truth, he could unresolve this and have me in court. But I'm not lying, telling the truth. He assaulted me for no reason, and he pulled a Jesse Smollett. He tried to use the N-word as something to derail the case, or you know, chase this rabbit over here, red herring, as I call it. And it wasn't even that factor in there. He made this all up on cloth. And you would just have to see the transcript. I got the whole file if you would like to have it out of my car. But his transcript, and once you read that, you can't do that but laugh and say, I can't believe we get this guy's money. The city has already cut off all ties with him, as far as I know, with giving him money for projects. And one more thing that happened Saturday night, there was a police chase and went down my street, Poplar Street, that like was doing over 100 miles an hour, and then ended with a crash on Melody Lane. And I believe that, I don't know how anybody survived, and Georgia State Patrol was out there investigating the matter, had it blocked off the next day. And the way of it, like somebody had been killed, probably two people at least. And it was nasty, it was ugly. And we hadn't seen nothing in it about the news or anything. And there may be reasons it's kept quiet, you know, they're investigating. But people don't need to be coming down Poplar Street at 100 miles an hour unless it's a terrorist attack or something, they have a reason to be chasing. And that's